Speaking of big Thanksgiving dinners, it is time for our annual trip to Donna Wyoffen's house.
She has some great ideas to make your feast stand out. It's time for this year's edition of A Very Donna Thanksgiving.
Back in the kitchen with Donna for the 28th year.
Yes, we were trying to figure out how long it was, and I guess it's been 28 years we've done a turkey.
Donna, we are thankful for you. This is such a special tradition for us. Thank you for having us over again.
Again and again. I love it. I love it.
The bird looks beautiful.
It does. I put it in, and it's about 4 or 5 hours for this bird because it's about 19 pounds.
So what's the rule when you're cooking a turkey?
Well, you have to have it in the oven until the thigh is 165 and then the breast is 165 in the breast and 175 in the thigh. So you need a thermometer to guide you. So put it in
and
the oven.
And don't depend on this little pop-up thing.
No, that doesn't. You can't depend on that. And then always check it also. You never want to depend on one thermometer. So I love this digital thermometer. And you just put it in and it instantly will read what it is. This has been out of the oven for a little while, but this was cooked till 165, 175 there.
Now, if you're having people over, how do you know how big of a turkey to get? What's the rule for that?
Who cares?
You don't care? It's not like
just get the biggest one you can.
Yeah, you know, this is for you guys. And how many are there? There's 4 of you, and I'm sending it to the studio, so it's about 19 pounds.
So whatever fits in the oven is what you want.
Yeah, absolutely.
So this is something new.
Yes. You know, you have to take the turkey out of the oven, and it should rest about 20 minutes or 30 minutes if it's a bigger bird. Why not have vegetables all ready to go and put it in the oven, like turn up the oven a little bit to 425, roast it for about 20 to 30 minutes, and then everybody has the vegetables they like. You know how the picky eaters, and some people like this, some people like that.
Just olive oil?
Olive oil, except for the carrots and the Brussels sprouts. I did both olive oil and maple syrup.
Ooh,
and so
delicious.
You put that in a little baggie and squish it around. And so those will roast and they'll be a little bit sweet and really good.
And then everybody can take what they like.
Yes,
I love that. Plus,
right,
it's so beautiful.
Right. You can also do the green bean casserole. And instead of using a can of soup, I made my own sauce. And this is a mushroom sauce. And it has a little bit of sherry wine in it. And it's absolutely delicious. It's better than the mushroom soup in a can.
Oh, and better for you. Oh, that, I can taste the sherry.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't that good?
It is good.
And so what I do, you can do this at the last minute. And I made this ahead and froze it. So this can be made, the sauce can be made ahead. Freeze it, and then when you're ready to do the beans, you pour it on the beans, and you put it in the oven and warm it up. And then you can put the onions on if you like.
Yeah, mashed potatoes?
Yes, and those are made ahead. Those are about 3 days ahead. And those are made, they have a little bit of cream cheese and a little bit of sour cream.
Cream cheese and a little white pepper, right?
Yes, and a little bit of sour cream, too.
What if you don't want to do a whole big bird?
That's what my story is today. Lots of people just want to do a breast. You know, they waste a lot of this, and it's easier. So you buy a breast, and I thawed it out. I'm going to give you instructions on what to do. It's best to cut out the backbone. I didn't want to gross you out, so it's in the back plastic bag. It's in the back of the breast. You cut out the backbone because it sits better in the pan, and you can use this to make gravy if you want to ahead of time. But then I just butter the breast, and I'm going to put it in the oven. The instructions will be online, too, because this is kind of important. You put it in the oven at 325 until it reaches 130. Now, that's still raw. Mm-hmm. So you take the bird out of the oven, reset the oven to 475 or 500, put the turkey back in until it reaches 165. You have a brown, golden brown bird, juicy in the middle, and it's perfectly done. Again, 325 until this reaches 130. It's not done yet. Take it out of the oven, reset the oven to 475, put it back in until it's done at 165.
And is it much shorter than a whole turkey?
Yeah.
How much time did it take?
Well, that takes about 2 or 3 hours,
okay.
So that's really fast.
That's a great idea.
And this way it's brown and juicy, too. I have one more side dish. It's a sweet potato recipe, and the sweet potatoes have milk, eggs, and brown sugar in it, and a little streusel topping. Somebody said, I think this is dessert.
That's what I thought. I thought it was an apple crisp.
And gravy. We can't forget the gravy. What do? I save my juice for next year. I have a little sign on here. It says, Turkey Broth, November 2018. So this is my broth from last year. And so I can make my gravy ahead of time. I don't have to do it to the last minute when I have the vegetables in the oven. I can save it ahead of time. And this juice from this turkey is right here.
For next year.
For next year. And I put it in here, and I've got my nice broth, and I stop right there, and all the fat is on the top.
The gravy separator. That's a great, great gadget.
And so I'll put that in my jar. And next year, when it's our 29th year, I'll say turkey from 2019.
So what's the best way to carve a bird?
I don't know. What do you want to do? You take off. You're going to tie it?
No, I'm not going to tie it.
Oh, God.
I'm going to watch you.
No, well, you know, you first you take off the leg.
That's your favorite.
That's the best part.
That's Mark's favorite.
Really?
The drumstick. Oh, yeah.
And look at this bird. I mean, it just falls apart. It's just as tender as can be. And then what you're really supposed to do is take the breast and cut it off. I won't be able to do this the whole time on the air. You're supposed to cut it off and put this part on the carving board. Oh, look at this. You won't believe this.
Oh, and we forgot to mention you put a whole onion in the cavity instead of the stuffing, which you never recommend.
And then you take this breast and you carve it this way, like this. You take it like this and carve it like this. And it's a little bit juicier.
Against the grain a little bit?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
But look at this unbelievable juicy breast.
Done to perfection, Donna.
Another Thanksgiving in the books.
You know why you wanted me to do this?
Yeah, exactly.
Thanks, Donna. Happy Thanksgiving.
I knew you couldn't resist.
Mm. Oh,
thank you, Donna. Happy Thanksgiving to your whole family.
Thank you to you, too.
We'll be right back.